A student fires a cannonball diagonally with an initial speed of 33 meters per second. Neglect drag and the initial height of the cannonball. All right, so, and we're also given this angle of 67 degrees. All right, so in this problem, we've broken things up into our horizontal and our vertical components, so it's kind of like two separate problems. And let's go ahead and start finding our given. We should also automatically break this diagonal into the horizontal and vertical components. I'm going to label these hypotenuse, adjacent, and opposite sides. All right, that 33 meters per second, that is our diagonal velocity. So I'm going to put that on the hypotenuse. It won't go into the horizontal or vertical components. Then I know this is a free fall problem, so my accelerations are 0 and negative 10 meters per second squared. Remember, I'm always going to find the positive direction as up and to the right. And finally, for y, I'm going to look at the rise only, which means that when this cannonball reaches its highest point, which is kind of covered up by my 33 right there, that final velocity is going to be 0. Let me write that with a pen. All right, so we'll start off by doing our trigonometry. So to get A, I'm going to do h cosine theta. And when I plug in my values, I get 12.9 meters per second. That can go as my initial vertical, my initial horizontal velocity. Then I can use sine. So this is going to be, let me write that as h sine theta. And then for mine, I got 30.4 meters per second. And for me, that is my initial vertical velocity. All right, I can go ahead and get my time interval by doing v final minus v initial divided by t, divided by a, which gives me 3.04 seconds. I'm going to go ahead and fill out a couple of my answers on the left side. The initial horizontal speed was 12.9. Again, that's velocity just without the sign. My vertical was 30.4. It's a great idea to check these as you go on positive physics. The cannonball rose for, I just found that, 3.04 seconds. Finishing out my y side, to get my displacement, I can do v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. And plugging that in, I got 46.2 as my vertical displacement, which is my maximum height. So remember, we analyzed the rise only here, but for x, we're going to analyze the total. So I need to take this time, and I need to double it. So I'm going to use that when the object goes up and down. That's when I'm going to double my time. This is different from complete problems one. All right, so that gives me a total flight time of 6.08 seconds. My horizontal velocity remains constant, acceleration 0. And so my displacement is, just take that constant velocity times the time, and I get 78.4 meters. All right, let's take a look at one more problem since these are tricky. In this problem, a student wants to fire a cannonball diagonally such that the ball will reach a maximum height of 45 meters and land 69 meters from the cannon, measured along the ground. All right, so in this one, we're going to work backwards. So that maximum height of 45 meters, that maximum height is measured up and down, so that is going to be my vertical displacement. It's positive, our positive directions are up and to the right. And then land 69 meters away from the cannon measured along the ground. The ground is horizontal, so 69 meters. All right, This is free fall, so my accelerations are 0 and negative 10 meters per second squared. I'm also going to use the fact that I'm just going to analyze the rise only for y, and I'll use the making the final velocity 0 for me if I just look at the rise only. All right, if I do that, now I have enough given to go ahead and solve the vertical side. I memorize the equation that the initial velocity will equal plus or minus the square root of negative 2a delta y. And plugging that in, I actually get exactly 30 meters per second. I can find my time then by doing v final minus v initial divided by the acceleration, which gives me exactly 3 seconds. So how long did the cannonball rise? That's our first answer, is 3 seconds. What was the cannonball's total flight time? Well, once again, I can double this to get 6 seconds. Working backwards to get the velocity, I can just do, and remember this velocity is going to be constant, so for both of these, I can just do my displacement divided by my time, or 69 divided by 6, which will give me 11.5 meters per second, and it's constant. All right, total flight time over here was 6 seconds for me. This is, at what speed does the cannonball need to be launched? We actually don't have this answer yet. What we need to do is do our trigonometry. In this case, we were working backwards, so our trigonometry came at the end. So I'm going to label my triangle, hypotenuse, adjacent, and opposite sides. The horizontal is 11.5 for the initial velocity. This is my initial velocity triangle. And the vertical is 30 meters per second. I can use the Pythagorean theorem to get my hypotenuse, or the square root of O squared plus A squared, which gives me 32.1, keeping 3 sig figs, meters per second. Then to find my angle theta, I can use theta equals inverse tangent of O divided by A. And that gives me 69.0 degrees.